So we're sure that the Pi UFL interface is successfully logging onto the Pi server, creating tags, and writing data. But what if you don't want the Pi UFL interface to actually be creating tags? Well, then you're going to have to create the tags on the Pi server yourself before the Pi UFL interface attempts to write to them. Now I'm just going to show you a little bit about that. To build points, we're going to go to Points, Point Builder, and I'm just going to search for the Pi tags that we have already. And you can see them here. So these are a bunch of tags that were created by the Pi UFL interface. Pi UFL tags are even simpler than most other Pi tags. They really don't require many attributes at all, and all they really need is a Pi tag name. That's what the Pi UFL interface is looking for when it writes to the Pi tag. So if I wanted to create a new Pi tag, all I would need to do is just name it a new name, Pi UFL, maybe batch FL3 this time, and I'll give it a point source. You can give it UFL, that way the UFL interface will be able to read it, and you can know what your for sure what your point source is if you go to your ICU here and you look at your point source. These two should match. You also need to select the point type to match the type of data that you're writing to it. So float 32, that's good for me. And then we can also go to the archive tab and classic and security and system. All of these attributes, we don't need to do much at all about them. There's one or two that allow you to do some tweaking if you look in the manual, but really all you need is a name and a point source. Once you're finished editing your tag, all you need to do is press save to actually create the tag, and we'll see it appear in this list here. You can also use the Excel Pi Tag Configurator plugin to create many tags all at once.